Saina, and a very good morning to all of you. Please take your seats. First of all, I welcome you all here. My name is Vishali, and I'm going to teach you light in your science physics part, right?
Yes.
But before that, I would like to know your name, so let's have a quick introduction, right?
Yes.
Let's start from here. And I just want to know the places from where you have come, right?
Hi, my name is Nancy. I'm from Bangalore.
Sir, my name is Chandni from Bangalore.
Sir, my name is Simran from
Bangalore. Sir, I'm Sakshi from Bangalore.
Sir, my name is Anjali from Bangalore.
Sir, my name is Divya from Bangalore.
Sir, my name is Anjali from
Bangalore. Sir, my name is Shweta from
Bangalore. Sir, my name is Meenakshi, I live in Bangalore.
Sir, my name is Nimada from
Bangalore. Sir, my name is Sarini from Madhya Pradesh.
Sir, my name is Sarini from Bangalore.
My name is Anshita, I am from Bangalore.
My name is Priya from Bangalore.
My name is Shalita from Bangalore.
My name is Swatha from Bangalore.
My name is Prabhupada from Bangalore.
I'm Nartika from Sherpur.
My name is Mehak. I live in
Sherpur.
My name is Kushku from Dhamshan.
My name is Nikita from Patiala.
My name is Pooja from Patiala.
My name is Neha from Patiala.
My name is Samuk from Patiala.
My name is Amisha from Patiala.
My name is Sejal from Patiala.
My name is Lakshmi from Patiala.
My name is Amchand from Patiala.
My name is Mandrit from Patiala.
My name is Deepika from Patiala.
My name is Diksha from Patiala.
Thank you so much. So let's start with today's topic, and please make sure that you will not move ahead with any doubt. Wherever you have any question, you are always welcome, right? So feel free to ask any question. Let's start. Light. See, in the end of the 19th century, light was considered to be the particle nature, right? And the particle nature that was defined from the corpuscles this was the particle which was defining the light, right? But later on, Newton and Huygens, they gave the concept of wave, that light, it is of wave nature also. So there were some phenomena which came into existence, like light, it is having two natures, and that's why we call that light is of dual nature. Dual nature, you must have heard this word, which we call in Hindi double phase. In Hindi we call dogla, dogla, right? And dual nature means double faced, right? Similarly, light is having dual nature. It is having particle nature as well as wave nature. Now, the phenomenon which were explained on the basis of the particle nature, they were reflection and
refraction.
And the phenomenon which were explained on the basis of the wave nature, they are interference, then we have diffraction, and polarization. are explained on the basis of the wave nature, right? But later on, with the advanced stages, the light is explained. There are the phenomena which are explained with both the particle as well as the wave nature, and we call that branch of physics as quantum physics. And this deals with both the particle as well as the wave nature. Am I clear to everyone? Right. Now, from where do we get the light? Can anyone tell me which is the biggest source of light which we get? From where we get the maximum of the light?
Sun.
Sun, right? Sun is the best source of light. And you know, on this basis, we can classify, there are many objects which are luminous as well as non-luminous. Right? Luminous, the name itself is telling. Luminous means something which is bright. Jo chamak raha hai, right?
Star.
So, yes, very good. So, what is that? Sun and
stars.
See, these are the natural luminous sources. We have man-made luminous sources also. Like these lights which we can see here. Lamps, torches, very good. So, these are the man-made luminous sources. Then we talk about the non-luminous sources. Non-luminous sources, these are? Moon. It is not having its own light, it reflects sunlight, right? Now how do we represent the light? See, light is represented by a straight line. Is there something else which we add into this line? Is there something else which we add into this line? We add an arrow here. Yeah. And what does this arrow tells us? It tells us the direction in which the light is propagating, right? It tells us that the light is moving in this direction, right? So, this single line which is having a ray, which is having an arrow, that is called as a ray. Number of lines together, they make one beam. And these beams, they are of three types. The first one is your, which I have already drawn, that is the parallel, right? Then we have the converging beam. Converging, converge means to meet at one point, right? So when the number of rays, they are meeting at one point, that is called as the converging beam. So how do we draw it? That you draw number of rays, of course, with the arrows, right? So when they meet at one point, that is called as the converging beam. And the third one is our divergent. You must have seen while walking on the while traveling. Whenever the road work is going on, they always write road diversion. What does it mean? That you are going in some other direction. So diverging beam, number of rays, and all of them, they are going in different directions. So that's why we call it as diverging beam. And from one point, the rays, they are going in different directions. So these are
diverging.
So these are the different type of beams which we are talking about. Is that clear?
Yes.
And remember one thing, that whenever any object is at infinity, infinity means we don't know that what is the exact distance, right? Infinite, very far away. So the ray of light, which the beam of light which comes from the infinity, that is always taken as the parallel. Is that clear? That we always take as the parallel beam. Now, let's talk about some more simple terms in life. whenever light falls on any object, there are three things which happen, right? The first one, some of the light that will be reflected. Some part of the light that will be refracted. And some part of the light that will be absorbed. So whenever light falls on any object, three things are happening. Number one, light is reflected. Reflected means it is coming back into the same direction, right? Refracted means transmitted. It is going from that medium. And the third thing is absorbed. So medium will absorb the light. Now, how these things are happening? If the object on which the light is falling is perfectly smooth, then most of the light that will be reflected, right? If the object is transparent, the light will be refracted. And if it is the dark object, then it will be absorbed, right? Like you must have seen that some of the best absorbing bodies, they are black. The black color is the best absorber because it absorbs the light. So is that clear that whenever the light will fall, the three phenomena they will take place, but up to what extent they are taking place, that depends on the kind of the surface. If the surface is perfectly smooth, most of the light will be reflected. If the surface is transparent, the light will be transmitted, and in the terms of optics, we call it as refraction, right? And if it is a dark surface, then it is absorbed. Is that clear? So here, we are going to talk about these two topics, the reflection and the refraction. First of all, we'll talk about the reflection, right? In our day-to-day life, these days actually, everybody is very much aware of how do we look, right? So what do? Most of this time, especially the kids of your age, they spend in front of the mirrors, isn't it? And mirrors don't lie. They tell you the exact image, right? Yeah. So when we are standing in front of the mirror, we are the object. And whatever we have got in the mirror, that is the image. So these are the words which we use for the object and the image. जो मिरर के सामने है वो क्या है ऑब्जेक्ट और जो हम मिरर में देख रहे हैं वो क्या है
इमेज
सो मिरर्स दे आर टेलिंग यू द एग्जैक्ट इमेज राइट नाउ इमेजेस दे आर आल्सो ऑफ टू टाइप लाइक पीपल आल्सो दे आर Inside there is something else, but to the outer world, everybody is having some other face, right? So there are two kinds of images: real image and the virtual image. Real means. जो सच में है राइट जो सच में है सो दैट कैन बी ऑब्टेन्ड ऑन द स्क्रीन सो दिस इमेज व्हिच कैन बी ऑब्टेन्ड ऑन द स्क्रीन इज कॉल्ड एज द रियल इमेज राइट एंड रिमेंबर वन थिंग दैट रियल इमेज इज ऑलवेज
वर्चुअल
हाउ कैन रियल इमेज बी वर्चुअल रियल इमेज इज ऑलवेज
इनवर्टेड
एंड एज अ
स्मॉल इमेज
convention we call that real and inverted right so real image is the one which can be obtained on the screen and of course the virtual image virtual means dhoka theek hai dikh to raha hai but actually mein hai nahi so it cannot be obtained obtained on the screen right and real image it is
always inverted
And virtual image is always?
Erect.
Erect means upright, right? Now this is, these are the kinds of images which we can get from the mirrors. Now let's talk about the mirrors. First of all, we should know that what is a mirror? Mirror, it is a perfectly smooth, shining surface. And how do we make one mirror? See, if you take a glass which is transparent, right? From one side, you are painting it with silver, and the other side, you are painting it with red color, you must have seen, right? What is that red color? It is an oxide of lead, lead oxide, which is painted at the back, right? So the side on which the silver is painted, but actually in the old days the silver was used, nowadays aluminium is used. And why aluminium is used, can anyone tell? Cost factor, beta. Silver is costly in comparison to aluminium, right? And everybody is having the mirror. So everybody cannot afford silver mirror. So that is why aluminium is used for painting the shining surface of the mirror, right? So how do we represent the mirror? Like we draw a surface perfectly plain, and it is having oblique lines on one side. So this side, which is perfectly smooth, that is called as the reflecting surface. And the other one with the oblique lines, that is called as the non-reflecting surface. Clear to everyone? Now the types of mirrors. First of all, we'll talk about the plane mirror. Plane mirror, which is plane. See the ring? Koi teda meda nahi, it is all plane. So plane mirror is the one which is, whose reflecting surface is perfectly smooth, right? And this is the commonest mirror which we use in our houses, right? Now, what are the characteristics of the images which we get from the plane mirror? Characteristics matlab ki jab hum ek plane mirror ke samne khade hain, to what kind of image are we getting? Hame kaisi image mil rahi hai? Theek hai?
Real.
We are getting the virtual image.
Hai
na? वर्चुअल इमेज क्यों मिल रही है? बिकॉज जब हम खड़े हैं मिरर के आगे, ठीक है, अब जैसे मैं मिरर के आगे खड़ू तो मुझे बिल्कुल ऐसे ही दिख रही हूँ ना, मेरे पांव ऊपर तो नहीं जा रहे, उल्टा तो नहीं जा रही हूँ, है ना? अगर उल्टी होगी तो मैं इन्वर्टेड हूँ, तो मैं तो इन्वर्टेड हूँ, नहीं सीधी दिख रही हूँ, सीधी मतलब मेरे. तो व्हाट काइंड ऑफ इमेज इज दिस? वर्चुअल इमेज इज ऑलवेज इरेक्ट. सो द फर्स्ट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ the image which we are getting from a plane mirror is what? The image obtained from a plane mirror, it is always virtual and erect. Is that clear to everyone?
Yes.
Second, that when you are standing in front of the mirror, the height of the image and the object, they are exactly the same, right? Like, what does it mean? Height of the object, object kaun hai? Main? Aur image kya hai? Jo mujhe mirror mein dikh raha hai. अब मेरी हाइट मुझे से दिखेगी ना, दीपिका पादुकोण जैसी थोड़े ना दिखेगी, है ना? या उससे कम थोड़े ना हो जाएगी, ठीक है? So my height will be same as that of the image which I am watching in the mirror. So height of the image is always equal to the height of the object in a plane mirror, right? Then third characteristic, that the distance of the image is equal to the distance of the object from the mirror. That suppose I say that this is a mirror, right? And this is an object. I am denoting the object with O. And the distance of this object from the mirror is 10 cm. Then as per the characteristic, what should be the distance of the image from the mirror?
10.
That should also be very good.
10 cm.
Image represented by R. That means in all, what is the distance between the object and the image? 20 cm, right? So sometimes the children, they get confused in this, na? That in the question it is asked that what is the distance between the object and the image if the object distance from the mirror is given, na? So distance of the object from the mirror and the distance of the image from the mirror, they are equal. But the total distance of the object from the image, that will be taken from twice that of whatever is given for the object. Is that clear to everybody?
Yes.
Right. Now, the next characteristic of the image obtained by a plane mirror is that the image obtained by a plane mirror is laterally inverted. Right? Laterally inverted. See, in case of whatever subject you are reading, every time the meaning is given in the surname itself, the heading itself. Lateral means sideways, inverted means opposite, matlab side ulti. Theek hai? So when you are standing in front of the mirror, right ka ulta kya hota hai?
Left.
So you must have seen that if you want to make some style in front of the mirror on your right side, in the mirror it appears that you are doing it on your left. Have you ever noticed this thing?
Yes.
So what is this? This is lateral inversion, right? Lateral inversion is what? That whenever we are standing in front of a plane mirror, the left appears right and the right appears left. And this is called as the lateral inversion. And this is one of the characteristics of the image formed by a plane mirror. Am I clear to everybody?
Yes.
Right? So again, I am going to revise the characteristics of the image formed by a plane mirror. Number one, image formed by a plane mirror is virtual and
irrelative.
Image formed by the plane mirror, the distance of the object and the distance of the image from the mirror is always equal. The height of the object and the height of the image, that is always equal. And the image formed by a plane mirror is laterally inverted. Clear to everyone?
Yes.
Now, let's talk about the other type of mirrors. One we have already discussed, that is plane mirror. Now we talk about the spherical mirrors. I already explained you were drawing a straight line and that was representing the plane mirror. Now the spherical mirrors, that means these are the curved mirrors whose reflecting part has been taken from a sphere. From where do we take the spherical mirror? From a sphere. The part of a sphere which we take as a mirror, that is called as the spherical mirror. It is a curved surface. Is that clear to everyone? Now there are many spherical mirrors, but we are going to talk about two mirrors which are most commonly used. Concave mirror, convex mirror, right? Concave. What is the shape of a concave mirror? Both the mirrors are curved. But how do you distinguish between concave and convex? Sanji beta, stand up please. No hesitations, please. Yes. Yes, Peter.
Spherical को जब half करते हैं उनमें से concave convex दोनों लेते हैं.
हाँ जी.
जो concave mirror होता है, वो इसकी साइड मतलब जो शेडेड पार्ट होता है साइड में जब मिरर बनाते हैं तो साइड में शेडेड पार्ट आता है, तो उसका बाहर की साइड होता है और कन्वेक्स का अंदर की साइड.
वेरी गुड. राइट, कॉनकेव मिरर इज द वन. इफ यू हैव एनी डिफिकल्टी टू रिमेंबर दिस, रिमेंबर कॉनकेव. द एंड वर्ड इज केव एंड वी गो इनसाइड द केव. सो दिस इज हाउ यू ड्रॉ अ कॉनकेव. दैट मींस द रिफ्लेक्टिंग पार्ट ऑफ अ कॉनकेव इज कर्व्ड इनवर्ड्स एंड दिस इज हाउ वी ड्रॉ द non-reflecting part. Is that clear to everyone? So which mirror is this? This is your concave. And the convex mirror is the one whose reflecting part is curved outwards. Is that clear? Right? So this is your convex. Okay? Now, whenever we talk about any subject, there are certain terms, there are certain symbols which are used in that. In maths you must be using many symbols.
Yes.
In electricity you must be using many symbols. Similarly, this optics, the study of light, it is also having its own symbols. And let's see what are these, and we call them as the optical terminology, right? Common for both the mirrors, right? Let's start with the first term, that is, if I draw, which mirror is this?
Concave.
This is concave.
Okay.
Now imagine that if I extend this
sphere.
So what is this?
Sphere.
Sphere from which this mirror has been taken, right? Similarly, if I draw convex here and this is also an imaginary sphere from which this mirror has been taken, right? Now this reflecting surface, there must be some center point for this and for this also, right? So this center of the reflecting part, what do we call it? We call it as pole, right? This is called as pole and this is denoted by
P.
So what is this pole? The center of the reflecting part is called as the pole, right? Now, this mirror, this has been taken from a sphere. So obviously the sphere is also having some center. So we draw that center here and we denote it as
C.
Similarly,
center of curvature.
This is C and this is called as center of
curvature.
So second term which we use, that is
center of curvature.
Center of
curvature.
Which is represented by
C.
Now when we join this pole and the center of curvature, this is called as the radius of curvature and this is called as
R.
Right? And it is represented by
R,
right? In both the cases it is R. Right? Then this line which can be extended and which joins the pole and the center of curvature, this line is called as principal
axis.
Right? Then the next term which we use here, that is aperture. Aperture is actually the size of the mirror, right? So if we write it as mn, open end, this will be called as the aperture. You call it as the diameter of the reflecting part, or you call it as simply the size of the mirror. That is called as the aperture, right? Now, just now, some time ago, I told you that whenever an object is at infinity, what kind of rays come from that?
Parallel.
Right? Now, let's suppose that the parallel rays are coming. They fall on this reflecting part of the mirror. Now, when the rays fall here, what will happen? They will be reflected, right? So, these rays after reflection pass like this. And it is very important to draw the arrows, because arrows show you the direction in which the light is traveling, right? Again, if I take another ray. So, these rays, they are meeting at one point after the reflection. And this one point is called as the focus.
Focus.
What do you call it?
Focus.
Focus. Which is represented by capital F. Right? And this distance between the pole and the focus, that gives you focal length, which is small.
Smaller.
Right?
Smaller.
So next point is your
focus.
Focus, which is represented by capital F. And in case of the concave mirror, focus is the point where all the rays meet after the reflection, right? And in case of the convex, what is happening, that when the rays are coming, they fall on the reflecting surface and they are reflected back. Now these rays, when you produce them backward, they are meeting at one point. They are not actually meeting, they appear to meet at this point, right? So that is why it is virtual, because it is not actually happening, it appears that it is happening. So this point is the focus and this is the focal length, which is represented by small f, right? Now, how do we define the focus of a concave mirror? See, the focus of a concave mirror, it is a point on the principal axis where all the rays are meeting after the reflection. Right? Is that clear? Because the rays are actually meeting on the principal axis. But when we are talking about the convex mirror, in that case, the rays, they appear to diverge from a point. The point on the principal axis from where the rays appear to diverge, they are called as the, that is called as the focus of a convex mirror. Okay? And focal length, now when we are dealing with these mirrors, the mirrors which we are talking about, they have the small aperture, right? They are not very large ones, they are having the small apertures, and for them there is one relationship, that radius of curvature is 2 times the focal length. And this is very, very important relationship for the mirrors which we are dealing here. They are the mirrors with the small aperture. Their sizes are small and they always follow this relationship, that radius of curvature, which is represented by capital R, it is equal to 2 times the focal length. Right? And you can see from here also, this is what? Focal length, and the C has to be approximately equal, right?
Yes.
Here also, this will be followed, that radius of curvature is equal to 2 times the focal length. Clear to everyone?
Yeah.
Now let's come to the next topic. Whenever we are talking about concave and convex mirrors, we talk about that how do we use them, where do we use them, right? And how the image is formed, that what kind of image is formed, what are the characteristics of the image obtained by the concave and the convex mirror, and on that basis we will decide the uses, that why we are using in the particular areas. Just like I have finished off with the plane mirror. Plane mirror we are using for watching ourselves because it is giving the exact image, right? The mirror image. So when we talk about the concave and the convex mirror, how the image is formed, what kind of image is formed, what are the characteristics of the image obtained by the concave and the convex, and on the basis of the images obtained we will decide about that where do we use the concave and the convex mirror, right? So there are certain rules which we follow before drawing the diagrams. So let's talk about the rules for the image formation. Formation, the first rule, that when a ray falls parallel to the principal axis, then how it is reflected, right? So let's see that when a ray falls parallel to the principal axis, this is which mirror?
Concave.
What is this?
Parallel.
What is this? P.
Pole.
What is F?
Focus.
And what is C?
Center
of
curvature.
And this line which is joining the pole, focus and center of curvature, we call that as
focus.
Principal
axis.
We call that as principal
axis.
Right? Now I am saying that when a ray falls parallel to the principal axis. Right? Now let's take a ray. This ray is parallel to the principal axis?
Yes.
So the rule says that when a ray is falling parallel to the principal axis, then after the reflection it falls, it passes from the
focus.
It will pass from the
focus.
Right? Now this center of curvature, any line which is joining the reflecting path to the center of curvature, that is a normal. Normal to the surface. Normal means perpendicular. Right? So when this normal is joined at the point of incidence, this incident ray is making an angle with the normal, and what do we call that angle? Angle of
incidence.
The incident ray is making an angle with the normal, and that is called as the angle of
incidence.
Similarly, this is reflected ray. So reflected ray makes an angle, and that is called as the angle of
reflection,
which is represented by
R.
Clear? Similarly, this rule is applicable for the convex mirror as well. Let's see how. This is convex mirror. This is pole, focus, center of
curvature.
Okay. I am saying that ray is parallel to the principal axis, and this ray after reflection will pass from the focus. So focus I'll draw here. So this is the diverging mirror, right? Now we draw and join a line with the center of curvature. Okay. Now this is the incident ray. Incident ray makes an angle, and what is that angle? Angle of
incidence.
And this angle is angle of
reflection.
Okay. So this is the rule that whenever a ray is passing parallel to the principal axis, then it will always pass from the focus. This is rule number one. Right? Second is incident on the focus. When a ray is incident on the focus, so let's see concave mirror. Pole, focus, center of curvature. Now the ray is incident on the focus. This is focus. The ray is incident on the focus and it will pass parallel to the principal axis. Right? When you join this with normal, this is your angle of incidence and this is your angle of reflection. Right? So this is the rule number 2. That if a ray is incident on the focus, then it will pass parallel to the principal axis. Right? Similarly, you can show it for the convex also. This is the ray incident on the focus and it is reflected parallel to the principal axis. When we join this with the center of curvature, this is your angle of incidence and this is the angle of reflection. Right? Now the next is, next rule, rule number 3. That when a ray falls on the center of curvature. Center of curvature is C, right? Now the ray is incident on the center of curvature. Path, it comes along the same path on which it is incident. Can anyone tell me why? Yes? Yes, beta, speak up. Anji, get up.
जो line center of curvature से जाती है वो वापस उसी के path से वापस मुड़ जाती
है. This is the rule. That I know, but why?
What
you? No, okay, sit down, I'll tell you. See, when I told you that any line when you join it with the passing from the center of curvature, when you join it on the surface, then that is normal to the surface, right? And according to the laws of reflection, see, if this is a normal, this is an incident ray, and this is a reflected ray, which makes an angle R, the laws of reflection says that angle of incidence is always equal to the angle of reflection, right? Now suppose that if I take a mirror and if this is the normal, okay, and the ray is incident along the normal, means the jo iske upar ray fall kare ki wo kahan se fall kare, normal ke upar hi, in dono ke beech mein angle kitna ho gaya, दोनों के बीच में एंगल कितना हो गया, जो नॉर्मल था और जो इंसिडेंट रे था, उन दोनों के बीच में एंगल कितना हो गया, जीरो डिग्री. देयर इज नो एंगल बिटवीन देम, दैट मींस एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस इज इक्वल टू जीरो डिग्री. सो एंगल ऑफ रिफ्लेक्शन विल आल्सो बी
जीरो डिग्री,
बिकॉज़ द लॉ ऑफ रिफ्लेक्शन सेज दैट एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस इज ऑलवेज इक्वल टू एंगल ऑफ रिफ्लेक्शन. तो अगर एक रे नॉर्मल के अलोंग ही फॉल कर रही है, ठीक है, तो दोनों के बीच में एंगल कितना हो गया, जीरो डिग्री. जीरो डिग्री इंसिडेंट एंगल हुआ तो रिफ्लेक्शन एंगल कितना हो गया, जीरो डिग्री. इसीलिए जब रे नॉर्मल के लॉन्ग फॉर्म करेगी सेंटर ऑफ कर्वेचर पे, तो एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस कितना था, जीरो. तो उसी एंगल पे ये क्या करेगी, रिफ्लेक्ट. देयर विल बी नो अदर, राइट. सिमिलरली व्हेन वी टेक अ convex. Here also it will retrace its path. The ray will move back along the center of curvature and the reason is again the same. Clear to everyone? Huh? Now the last rule. The fourth one, that when a ray falls obliquely on the mirror, obliquely means at some angle, right? Concave. This is the pole. Focus. Center of curvature. Now at this point of incidence, at the pole is the point of incidence now, right? So it will follow the law of reflection and it will simply reflect back, right? And this is the center of curvature. ये कोल पे join कर रहे हैं, ठीक है? तो ये क्या है? Normal. तो ये कौन सा angle हो गया? Angle of incidence. और ये कौन सा हो गया? Angle of reflection. Clear to everyone? Similarly, for the convex, pole, focus, center of curvature. We are taking an oblique ray falling on the pole. This is reflected back and when we produce this principal axis, this is your angle of incidence and this is angle of reflection. So these are the four rules which are used in the image formation. Is that clear to everyone? The first rule was that when a ray is incident parallel to the principal axis, after the reflection it passes from the focus. If the ray is incident, second rule is, if the ray is incident on the focus, then after the reflection it passes parallel to the principal axis, right? The third one, if a ray is falling on the center of curvature, then it retraces its path. And fourth one, if the ray is falling obliquely on a mirror, then it is reflected at the same angle and you get the image. Is that clear? Now, nobody asked me that why we are studying these rules. Nobody asked that why we are studying these rules. Syllabus mein hai? Nahi. We are studying these rules because we have to show the image formation, right? And image formation we can show if there is the intersection of two rays at least. Right? From an object, there are infinite number of rays. But when you have to show the image formation, then at least there should be the intersection of two rays. That is why we are studying these rules, because out of these four, any two we will use to show the image formation in case of the concave and the convex. Clear to everyone? Okay? Now, before talking about the image, let's talk about that what kind of mirrors are these, right? We take a concave mirror. This is the pole, focus and the center of curvature. Okay? Now, the parallel rays coming from infinite source fall on the mirror, reflect and pass from the focus. Okay? Is it clear now why they are passing from the focus?
Yes.
Because just now we have started the rule and as per the rule, the rays which are parallel to the principal axis, they pass from the focus. So these are meeting at one point and I told you that where the rays meet at one point, what do we call that? Convergence. What do we call that?
Convergence.
So what kind of mirror is the concave mirror? It is a convergent mirror. What kind of mirror is this? converging mirror. ठीक है, नाउ कॉन्वेक्स पैरेलल रे पासिंग फ्रॉम द focus, you can draw the focus again because in case of the virtual you have to draw it again, right? So this point is the focus. Now you can see, just follow the direction of these rays which are reflected. They are going away, na? They are diverging. So what kind of mirror is this? Divergent, right? Converging, in which all the rays are meeting at one point after the reflection. Diverging, in which the rays appear to move away from each other. From one point, they are called as the diverging mirrors. Is that clear to everyone? Clear to everyone? Any question? Let's go to the next topic, shall we?
Yes.
Now I'll show you the image formation. Again, I am going to ask one question which I told you, that when an object is infinity, what kind of rays do we get?
Parallel.
And just now we have studied the rule that if parallel rays fall on the mirror, then what happens to them after the reflection pass from the focus? Okay? So there is nothing to think about, that we will draw, we'll place an object here. Okay?
Yes.
Then we draw with the discrete lines. Discrete मतलब ये dash dash वाली line, ठीक है? इसका मतलब होता है बहुत दूर से आ रहे हैं, infinity से, and it is not in the continuum. Means बहुत दूर से, ठीक है? And then it falls on the mirror. Similarly, you can take one more ray, parallel, and reflected, and it meets. Now, when the object is at infinity, where is the image formed? Where the two rays are meeting?
Focus.
So when the object is at infinity, what is the position of the image?
Focus.
What is the nature of the image? See, this image is formed in front of the mirror. You are obtaining it, so it is real image.
Real.
And real image is always
small
inverted. It is always inverted. So this means that when the object is at the infinity, the image is formed at the focus, and the nature of the image is that it is real and inverted, and its size is very very small, point sized. ठीक है? It is point sized. अरे वैसे भी सोचो, this is all physics. अगर कोई बहुत ही दूर चीज है, उसको तुम मिरर में देख रहे हो तो कितना सा दिखेगा? छोटा सा, है ना? तो वही बात है कि इतनी सारी हम चीजें कर रहे हैं कि रेज आ रही है यहाँ से वहां से, बट जस्ट अप्लाई द लॉजिक ऑल्सो दैट थिंक दैट इफ एन ऑब्जेक्ट इज एट अ वेरी फार ऑफ प्लेस एंड यू आर ऑब्टेनिंग इट्स इमेज इन द मिरर, तो व्हाट वुड बी द साइज ऑफ द इमेज? वेरी स्मॉल. सिमिलरली व्हेन द ऑब्जेक्ट इज एट इंफिनिटी, द ऑब्जेक्ट साइज इज वेरी वेरी स्मॉल, इट इज अ पॉइंट साइज. क्लियर टू एवरीवन? नाउ द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, नेक्स्ट केस, दैट when the object is beyond C. Beyond C, this is C. Object is beyond C, but it is not at infinity. It is somewhere between center of curvature and infinity, not at infinity, right? So we'll take the concave mirror. Today in your dreams you will just draw the concave mirrors, right? Because I'm going to take it all along. Pole, focus, center of curvature, and I said that object is beyond C. Okay? So object is represented by this. Why this arrow is upward? Because object will keep straight in front of the mirror, right? So I take one ray which is parallel to the principal axis, and parallel rays after the reflection pass from the
focus.
I take another ray which is passing from the center of curvature, and this ray retraces its path. So this is the point where these two rays are meeting, and I will draw the image like this. Now arrow is downward. That means what kind of image I have got? Ulti. CDP. जहाँ पे इंटरसेक्ट कर रही है वहाँ पे एरो बनेगा, तो एरो कैसे बन रहा है? उल्टा. तो इमेज कैसी होगी?
इनवर्टेड.
एंड इनवर्टेड इमेज इज
रियल.
ठीक है? और फ्रॉम द डायग्राम इट इज क्लियर, ऑब्जेक्ट का साइज बड़ा है, इमेज का साइज छोटा है. सो व्हाट काइंड ऑफ इमेज इज दिस?
डिमिनिश्ड.
सो व्हेन द ऑब्जेक्ट इज बियॉन्ड सी, इमेज इज फॉर्मड बिटवीन सी एंड एयर, एंड इट इज रियल एंड इनवर्टेड एंड डिमिनिश्ड. What kind of image is this?
Diminished.
Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay. Dono cases clear hai. First case, when the object is at infinity, image is formed at the focus, real and inverted and diminished. When the object is beyond C, image is between C and F, real and inverted and diminished. Now let's do the third case. When the object is at C, C means center of
curvature.
Okay? This is your mirror. I am saying that object is at C. Okay? We take a ray parallel. The parallel ray passes from the
focus.
And if we take another ray which is passing from the focus, that will go parallel. So you just see that it is meeting exactly at the center of curvature, and it is again ulti. So when the object is at the center of curvature, image is also formed at the center of curvature. It is real and inverted and size is same. Very good. The size is same, right? Now the next one, when the object is between C and F. Okay? So object between C and F. We take a ray parallel that will pass from the
focus.
We take another ray which will pass from the focus, and it goes parallel to the principal axis. Now these rays are meeting at this point, intersecting at this point. So we'll draw the image here. Again it is inverted. And you just see the size of the image. It is bigger than the object. So when the object is between C and F, the image is formed beyond C, and it is real, inverted and enlarged. Magnified or enlarged, one and the same thing, right? It is enlarged. Clear to everyone?
Yes.
Now the next is when the object is at focus. That means when the object is at F. Okay? So let's see. Now we place the object at the focus. Right? We take a ray which is parallel. The parallel ray that goes from the
focus.
Right? Another ray we can take which is passing from the center of curvature, and this retraces its path, and the image will be formed somewhere at infinity. So we say that when the object is at the focus, the image is formed at infinity, and it is real and inverted because it is on the same side. So it is real and inverted, and it is highly magnified. The size will be very big one, right? Then the last case of the concave mirror, when object is between P and
F.
It is between pole and focus, right? Again we draw the principal axis, pole, focus and the center of curvature, right? Now we are saying that the object is between P and
F.
Let's take an oblique ray. This will be reflected. If we take a ray which is passing from the center of curvature, now you can see that these two rays, they are diverging. That means they are not going to meet this side. So at this point, they are getting closer. So when we produce them back, they are going to meet somewhere. So let's see how. So at this point, behind the mirror, they are going to meet, and we get the image at this point. Now the arrow will be upright. An upright arrow means the image is erect.
Right?
So in this case, this is the exceptional case for the concave mirror where we get virtual and erect image. And again I tell you, why it is virtual? Because it is behind the mirror. It is not actually, the rays are not actually meeting, they appear to meet at that point, right? So we call that as virtual image, and virtual image is always inverted, right? So when the object is between P and F, the image is formed behind the mirror. The nature of the image is virtual and erect, and what is its size? It is magnified. So you get an image which is bigger in size than the object. Clear to everyone? So these are the six cases of the concave mirror. Now let's talk about the convex mirror. The first one. In the convex mirror, when the object is at infinity, okay? When the object is at infinity, we are placing the object here. The rays are coming again. What kind of rays we get from the object at infinity?
Parallel.
These will be reflected because they are falling on the mirror. So when we produce them, they will meet at the
focus.
Very good. Right? So this is the case in case of the convex mirror. When the object is at infinity, image is formed at the
focus.
Now this image is behind the mirror. So what kind of image is this?
Virtual
and
indirect,
right? And what is the size of the image? It is
dim
image, very good. Point size, right? So we get a virtual, erect and point-sized image. Now second case, when the object is between pole and infinity, any point before infinity, right? So what kind of image do we get here? Focus we can draw later on for this side, virtual side, right? So let's see that the object is somewhere here. We'll take a ray parallel which is reflected and it will pass from the focus, right? This is your center of curvature. We take a ray which is passing from the center of curvature and this ray retraces its path because it is along the normal. So this point we will get the image. Now again this image is behind the mirror. So what kind of image is this?
Virtual
and erect. And what is the size?
Image,
right? So again in case of the convex mirror, whenever the object is between pole and infinity, we are getting an image which is virtual, erect and diminished. In the first case also it was virtual, erect and diminished. So in case of the convex, we always get virtual, erect and diminished image. Clear to everyone? Okay. Now we have studied three mirrors, plane, concave and
convex.
In all the three cases, we are getting an erect image. Okay. But what is the difference between them? In the first case, plane mirror, the image is of the same size, isn't it? You are getting the same size image. In case of the concave mirror, in the exceptional case, when you get an erect image, that image is magnified. And in the case of the convex mirror, the image is diminished. So this is the difference between the three images, erect images. Clear to everyone? Now the last topic is, where do we use these mirrors? First of all, let's talk about the uses of concave mirror. Yes. Anyone? Do you know any use? Yes, Pachi.
Concave mirror is used in a solar
panel. Solar what?
Solar panels.
Yeah. Anyone else? Yes.
Torches.
Yes, very good. It is used in the
torches.
You were very close to that, solar, but not the panels. In the solar furnaces, it is used, right? Because actually, the concave mirror is the converging mirror. ठीक है? So converging mirror क्या करता है? सारी rays को एक point पे concentrate करता है. और furnace किस लिए होती है? Furnace का मतलब क्या होता है? भट्टी. जिसमें हमने आग जलानी है. अब आग जलाने के लिए रेस को तुमने एक पॉइंट पे कंसंट्रेट करना है, तो कौन सा मिरर यूज करोगे जो कन्वर्जिंग होगा? दैट इज व्हाई द कॉन्केव मिरर इज यूज्ड. क्लियर टू एवरीवन?
डेंटिस्ट ऑल्सो.
वेरी गुड. इट इज यूज्ड बाय द डेंटिस्ट ऑल्सो, है ना? क्योंकि दांत में दर्द हो रही है तो डेंटिस्ट ने भी दांत उखाड़ के थोड़ी ना बाहर निकालना है. वो उसको देखने के लिए इमेज के लिए ही नीड समथिंग विच विल गिव द मैग्नीफाइड इमेज. तो मैग्नीफाइड करने के लिए ही नीड्स द कॉन्केव मिरर. एनीथिंग एल्स?
फॉर लाइट्स.
Headlights of the cars, very good. So these are the uses of the mirrors. The concave mirrors, they are used by the ENTs. ENTs are ear, nose and throat specialist doctors. They see the inner parts with the help of the concave mirrors, right? Similarly, the dentists, they also use the concave mirrors to see your denture, right? Then they are used in the torches, they are used in the search headlights, they are used in the car headlights, they are used in the solar furnaces. Right? So these are the various uses of the concave mirrors. Now let's talk about the convex mirror. Any use of convex mirror?
Some vehicles may sight seeing through the vehicle.
Yes, the rear view mirrors in the vehicle. Very good. They are the convex mirrors.
Yes.
Now, can anyone tell me why do we use the convex mirror as a rear view mirror?
क्योंकि इसमें जो साइड्स की जो पीछे वस्तु वो छोटी छोटी से हमें सारा दिख जाता
है. Yes, very, very valid reason. See, in the convex mirror, if you have anything, any doubt in your mind, ना कि why we are using, अब mirror use करेंगे तो क्यों use करेंगे? Image के लिए use कर रहे हैं, ठीक है? अब reason आपको पूछे कि इस mirror को क्यों use करें, तो उस mirror की image के characteristic लिख दो. Very valid, है ना? Very logical. कि हम किसी mirror को क्यों use करेंगे? क्योंकि उसमें जो image बन रही है, उसके जो characteristic है, उसके कारण use कर रहे हैं ना? तो convex mirror use कर रहे हैं, rear view mirror. Rear view मतलब पीछे का देखने के लिए, ठीक है? सबसे पहले the image formed by the convex mirror is virtual and erect. जो भी आ रहा है पीछे से वो आपको दिख रहा है, सीधा दिख रहा है. अब ड्राइवर गाड़ी चला रहा है, उसको पीछे से उल्टा ट्रक आता हुआ दिखेगा तो उसका ध्यान तो ट्रक में जाएगा ना, है ना? सो दैट इज नॉट डन. सो वर्चुअल एंड डायरेक्ट इमेज. सेकंड, इमेज फॉर्मड बाय द कॉन्वेक्स मिरर इज डिमिनिश्ड. डिमिनिश्ड मींस इट इज स्मॉलर इन द साइज एक्चुअली, राइट? देन इट गिव्स अ वाइडर फील्ड व्यू. बहुत पीछे तक का आपको फील्ड व्यू दिख जाएगा, ठीक है? सो दिस इज द रीजन दैट व्हाई वी यूज द कॉन्वेक्स मिरर. एनी अदर यूज ऑफ कॉन्वेक्स मिरर? धर्मशाला वालों बताओ, तुम्हारे रास्ते में लगे हैं कॉन्वेक्स मिरर? बिकॉज आई एम ऑल्सो फ्रॉम दैट प्लेस.
स्ट्रीट लाइट?
नॉट द स्ट्रीट लाइट, बट इन द रोड्स इट इज यूज. यू वर नियर टू दैट. यस, हिली एरियाज वेयर देयर आर ब्लाइंड कर्व्स, the convex mirrors, they are used on the blind curves to see the traffic which is coming from the other side, which you cannot see otherwise, right? So hai na ye McLeodganj ke raste mein, everywhere they are in the Camden area, I have seen many times, right? So the convex mirrors, they are used to see the traffic on the blind curves, right? So these are the uses of the concave and the convex mirrors. And I hope it is clear to everyone. And now I want to tell you one thing. Just enough of the real and inverted images. I've got three spoons with me, right? And every day we are using them. So you just see that this part from which we put in our mouth, from where we scoop the food, that is curved inwards. So which mirror is that?
Concave.
That is concave. And the
convex.
Concave mirror gives you what kind of image? Real and inverted. Means when I see my face, I'll see my face opposite, downwards, right? And the convex mirror always gives the erect image, right? So when you see your face in the back side of the spoon, you will see the face as it is, right? And you can try it. I'll just give one spoon. You can silently pass it on to everyone in your row and just see your face. Ulta seedha dono taraf se, right? किसी को दोनों तरफ से उल्टा दिखेगा तो बताना मुझे,
राइट?
So everybody is seeing?
Yes, ma'am.
I hope now it is clear that what do you mean by an inverted image and what do you mean by an erect image. You can see. So that's all about the light, the mirrors. Now, whatever we have done, let's take a quick test of that.